This is what we are actually talking about. Let me ask, have you seen anyone walking backwards before? No normal human person will be walking backwards without any reason. Now, when you walk backwards two steps and you walk forward two steps, you cover the same distance. So for distance, you don't have a negative distance. I can't tell you today I walked negative 50 kilometers to the market. Was I walking backwards or flying? No. Only cars, motors can move backwards. Even when they move backwards, they move in a positive distance. So absolute values means positive numbers alone, no matter how the direction is. And we use this bar to denote absolute values. You can also find this bar on your calculators, but it has been written in short ABS. So when you press the shift key and ABS, you'll be seeing this very bar on your screen. So I press my shift and ABS so that I get my absolute function. So you can see it here on the calculator. You first press your shift key and you search for your absolute sign, ABS. It's on top of the HYP. So shift and that, you see your absolute value. So anything I write there is within what? An absolute bracket. So it's good to know. Now, absolute simply means positive number because it's a distance. So when we have absolute x, it simply means the value is always greater or equal to zero. There is no way it can give you a negative number. For example, taking the number 9. When we move 2 units to the left and 2 units to the right, what happens? When I move 2 units to the left, 1, 2. Even though the number here is negative 2, but I've moved what? 2 distance. So absolute number 2 gives us positive 2 because I moved 2 times backwards. The negative only shows that I moved backwards, but the distance is what? 2 units from the start point. The same way when I move forward 1, 2, is still what? Absolute value of 2 is still what? Still 2, because I moved 2 units from what? The starting point. So when we talk of absolute values, it's always positive. For example, absolute value of negative 10 will give you a positive 10. It means when I move 10 backwards, I still have 10 units. So that's what the absolute sign tells us. Now, some few properties of absolute numbers. When you have absolute A times B, it can be written as absolute of A alone times the absolute of B alone. And it gives us A times B, which is the same as AB. When we have absolute negative AB, it can be split as absolute negative A times absolute B. And we said absolute of any negative number is still what? Positive. So I'm going to get A times B, which is the same as what? AB. So anytime numbers are placed within the absolute value, when we have negative values, it still comes out as what? Positive values. So this is the brief introduction to what absolute values, you may be using them much more earlier or in the near future. I would like you to take this assignment and try your hands on it. In our next video, we will see whether you are able to do it or not. If you are unable, don't forget to subscribe and send us your problems and we will be glad to help you. So you can take this assignment. One, you have to show whether or not the following numbers are rational or not. So if you write the following in interval forms, and also try our hands on solving for S. So these are a few questions you can lay your hands on after watching this tutorial, and they will be of great help to you. Okay, hope to see you another time. But don't forget to like and subscribe for our channel. We hope you will be enjoying this. So meet again. Thumbs up.